It sure was sweet to be elite. But for the Florida State women's basketball team, the journey has meant much more than the final destination. Reporter Michael Hudak tells us the story of a program, its fans, and what it meant for the Noles to be in such select company come tournament time.
Nothing in life is guaranteed. Not victory, not prosperity, not even tomorrow. When success is achieved, it is cherished. But what defines success? Is it being the best at what you do? Being better than the day before? Maybe it's achieving a goal.
You know, everybody has different goals and different aspirations in life. I think as long as you're happy with what you're doing and you're feeling like your life is fulfilled and doing the most out of you, I mean, I think that's success.
Just growth. I think so much is, you know, if you take something from that situation and you can, it prepares you for something later on in life, I think that's a big deal.
Florida State women's basketball embarked on a journey in the 2016-2017 season. Only they could create their own success. Only they could achieve it.
I think all the little things, the consistency, the trust, the chemistry, a lot of it's off the court as well. Just having that mentality and creating that culture from day in and day out, something that you came into practice every day, and this, you know, practicing like the champion, that championship mentality.
A final record of 28-7. A school record 9 victories against ranked opponents. The previous mark was 6. Senior guard Leticia Romero was named a first-team All-American for the 3rd time. Junior Shaquayla Thomas became the school's first ACC Player of the Year. And finally, a berth in the Elite 8 for the 3rd time in program history. But perhaps no achievement surpasses sharing a moment with their fans on game day and on one of the most important days of the season.
It was amazing, you know, actually having, you know, real face-to-face conversations with a lot of our supporters, a lot of people that love to watch us play, and, you know, just actually saying thank you for all that they do. It's special just because, you know, without them, we probably wouldn't have won a lot of games that we have, just in terms of how they, you know, get us going, especially on the defensive end, and just give us that energy. It goes back to what we talk about, the family atmosphere here at Florida State.
The magic didn't stop there. The Seminoles went dancing for the 16th time in program history, and FSU hosted the first 2 rounds of the tournament for the 2nd time in 3 years. The goal? To keep dancing.
The start of Western Illinois, when we didn't play that good, the fans are still cheering. Same with Missouri, knowing that our fans continue to support us if we win, if we lose, if we have a good game, if we have a bad game. And I think that's what we, you know, appreciate the most.
Despite an earlier exit than they hoped from the Elite 8, the Seminoles made it there for the 2nd time in 3 years. Florida State never stopped believing, and the fans never stopped believing in them.
We've kind of created a culture where women's basketball is actually, you know, fun to watch. We've kind of changed that culture here in Tallahassee.
People coming to support you, to see where you are going to end up in the tournament, what seed we're going to be. I mean, all that is amazing. But having people that care about that and that want you to be good and see you doing big things, I think it's just an amazing feeling. I can't even thank them enough for that support and that love.
2016 to 2017, a season that the players, fans, and the program will never forget. I'm Michael Hudak for Seminole Sports Magazine.
The Seminoles will return 9 of 13 players next season as they look to make the push to the Final Four for the first time in program history. When we